Hi there, welcome to yet another Python series. In case you weren't sick of us already, we're back for more. And this time, we're gonna focus in on some tools for data science. Now, before we get into it, there's really three main questions that we wanna be able to answer. Who are we? Who are you? And what is it that we're going to be doing here? So let's start off with, well, who are we?
So my name is Susan Ibeck. And I am definitely a data geek, also known as Hockey Geek Girl Online. And one of the things I love to do when I'm not sitting at front of a terminal coding, I'm probably either maybe running a marathon or maybe listening to some good thrash metal.
As for me, I'm Christopher Harrison. I've been a geek for about as long as I can remember. I'm now a program manager at with Academic Ecosystems inside of Microsoft. I have a propensity to tell dad jokes, as well as saying the word propensity. I'm a husband, I'm a marathoner, and I'm a father of a four-legged child, also known as a dog. So let's talk a little bit then about like expectations, prerequisites, if you will. Basically, who are you, and why is it that you might be interested in something like this? So the assumption that we're making is that you've done a little bit of Python and you're looking to just get in and start to explore data science. That maybe there's a quick start that you want to check out and you're just trying to figure out, like, what are these different things that I'm being told to just follow along with and just kind of run some code. Hopefully we'll explain some of what's going on inside of there.
Yeah, because a lot of times when a lot of people get into Python because they have an interest in exploring that world of data science, but opening up that first data science tutorial, you've got all the data science concepts and at the same time, all kinds of new Python libraries and commands that you might not be familiar with. So what we're hoping here is introduce you to some of those Python tools and some of those libraries so that maybe when you do that data science tutorial, you can focus more on just new data science concepts.
Yeah, so that's really what it is that we're going to be doing here, is introducing those libraries, walk you through some common tools, techniques, and navigate through some common scenarios. And the way that we're going to be doing it is by walking through really the some basic scenarios, and you'll notice that there'll be a little bit of a common thread throughout a lot of these modules, where a lot of these modules, a lot of these concepts will build on the ones prior. That being said, they're still all designed to be snackable, all just like really short. So you can jump in, take a look at the particular tools, concepts that you need, and then jump back out from there.
Yeah, but you'll find it easiest to learn for these particular series if you do watch them sequentially. You can still skip the PowerPoint presentation and jump straight to the demos if you're one of those people who just show me the code in action. You can still absolutely do that. Just follow the code modules. But you will probably find it easier to follow the concepts if you do the modules in order.
Yeah, so let's head on into it.
Let's start coding.